Now bring in the members of our jury. Elizabeth, John, and Dan voted out at the last tribal council. All right, let's start with the immunity challenge. It's been a long time since we have had a challenge go nearly 6 hours. Christian, on your way to ultimately winning, you were very open and vulnerable in saying, I could actually maybe win this one, so I'm just not gonna ever give up.
Well, back home, I self-sacrifice to endlessly to try to please people, and I had to remind myself that I was in a game that I'll probably only get one chance to play. So when I'm in that dilemma, I can always look back on that time I was talking to Jeff for 5.5 hours and when he was my captive audience. I can remember that memory.
I was captive.
Oh, you were captive, yes. Yeah, oh, yeah, you were captive.
Captivated.
Yes. Yeah.
I couldn't go anywhere. And Alec, you were toe-to-toe with Christian.
Yeah.
Christian talked the entire challenge. You barely said a word. When did it start to kick in that you were actually hurting?
So for me, I told you guys all from the beginning, I'm not stepping off until I win, just because I feel like I'm at a really vulnerable place in this game. And so that was my mentality going into it. Next thing I know, it was like hour 5. I remember just trying to focus on something and closing one eye and shaking my head. And then I just remember being really dizzy.
Nick, one of the other elements was you had a chance to sit out and not compete for immunity and have nachos instead, which you took part in, along with Carl and Angelina. Was there any impact?
No, there wasn't at all. If anything, there was other people saying, man, if I'd have known that was going 6 hours, I'd have set out and had some nachos too. So the decision we made looked brilliant.
But regardless, I think it says something about someone's character, their position in the game, if they're gonna opt out.
But Jeff, he's eaten 3 rewards. I haven't eaten anything but a scoop of rice here and there. That was the only opportunity that I had to get some food. So all I can do is hope my timing was right, that I chose to sit out, give myself some nourishment, have the strength physically and mentally to continue on with my alliance, and I roll with it.
I'm calling a spade. You were confident enough to eat nachos. That it is what it is.
I'm sorry, Jeff. I mean, Survivor in every way is about calculated risk. You know, eat a nacho is calculated risk. Also, to not eat the nachos is a calculated risk. Also, what that risk reveals about your calculation. I think that's what we're talking about right now.
You know what, Jeff? I think the concept of calculated decisions is really salient right now. Everything is done with intention. You know, should I get this food? And am I feeling in a good place with the people that say that they trust me and who I say I trust? And that was something that was part of my calculation as well.
Allison, buy that?
I don't buy a lot of what Angelina's selling anymore.
To be honest, Jeff, like, it's hypocritical for Allison to say that when the 3 people who are chiming in, these 3 Goliaths, they made a very calculated decision last tribal council.
What do you mean? What's the decision they made?
Yeah, I'll get there.
Mike's covering his face.
No. So it's okay, Mike. I'm gonna be delicate about it, but I'd rather much talk about how the tribal lines have fallen and there's new alliances, there's new relationships, than talk about a decision to eat nachos, because I think that it's so much more than that, Jeff.
So, Alec, is this moment that Angelina's talking about, it goes back to the last tribal, is it still relevant right now?
Well, I definitely think we've crossed tribal lines. There's no question there. New alliances have been formed, but I don't think they've truly been tested yet.
And that's the trick in Survivor, is like, are we gonna just talk about it or are we gonna do it?
And Allison, really, the numbers are small enough now that you better be playing your own game.